This is the second video in a two-part series on Excel regression. The first video showed a simple example using Excel regression. This video will go over more complex functions that can be used with Excel regression. In the previous video, two simple equations were shown. These equations, when broken down, take the form of y equals ax plus b and y equals ax squared. The regression tool in Excel is, however, capable of handling far more complicated equations, as long as they can be altered for Excel to understand. Here you can see the original two equations from the previous page. These next two, however, are a little bit different. They still start with the y equals, but instead of x and x squared, we have a log of x and a z squared. We have a log of x, a z, and a w to the 3/2. This first one I'm going to step through setting up in the Excel spreadsheet. So if I switch over to Excel, here I have on a spreadsheet three columns of data, y, x, and z. X and z, in this case, are the independent variables. They're the x variables. But in our equation, we have a log of x and a z squared. So instead of keeping it x and z, we need to change them. So I don't have to delete them, I'm just going to select them and move them over. Because what we need to do is when we run this through regression, our new variables, log of x and z squared, need to remain together. And it makes it much easier if they're next to the independent variable y. For log of x, I need to enter equals log of x, and this is a base 10. And then for z, it's a z squared. Now I have both of these set up so that I can run regression on them. I'm not, however, going to step through the regression for this particular example. The answer would be relatively straightforward. The coefficient for log of x will be given as well as the coefficient for z squared. Instead, I'm going to do the regression step through on a more complicated equation. So I'm going back to our problems. And here we have y equals b log of x plus cz plus dw to the 3/2. I don't have a w column of data on my spreadsheet. But if I did, I would simply alter this the same as I did the ones previously to have, instead of w, w to the 3/2. On this next page, we have linear regressions that cannot be used with Excel, except some of them can be altered to be used indirectly. For example, this first one, y equals ax. You know, looking at this, you're going to use two columns of data, a column of data for y and a column of data for x. But you can recognize a problem immediately with the fact that x is a power of a, and this needs to be changed. So this equation has to be altered. And the best way to get the x down from being the power of a is to use log. So log of y equals log of a times x. By taking the log of both sides, you ended up with the log of y. But also, when you have the log of a to the x simply comes down and is multiplied by the log of a. Now, this equation can be used within the Excel regression. This next equation, however, only has an x. There is no y. So this equation can't even be used. Because to use an equation, you have to have both an independent and a dependent variable. These next two equations, you can see, have x's and y's. However, there's an immediate problem when you look at this. If this is your original equation, you should not be able to have specific y values. This first one can be broken down to be y to the 4th equals c over b minus a over b x squared. But the problem lies in the fact that the original y is not linear. You can't alter a y as you did up here, but if you don't have an original linear y, you can't expect it to have a list of linear y values. So in Excel, where you have a list of y's, in the case of this other equation, unless it told you you have y to the 4th, you probably won't be able to use this equation at all. For the 4th equation, you wouldn't even be able to break this down to separate your y's from your x's. So that can't be used. This final equation, however, although it looks very similar to these first two, it has the y's, x's, and z's, yet the y is remaining by itself. you can break this one down to be able to have each of these individual within your Excel spreadsheet. The example that I'm going to be taking from this to use with Excel is going to be this first one. The log of y equals log of a times x. So if we take this equation and take it over to our spreadsheet, we have a column of y values and a column of x values. So what we need to do, instead of y values, we need to change those to log of y to make it match the equation we're going to start. So what I'm going to do is I'm still going to move over our x values, but I'm only going to move them over one spot. And here we have our log of y, and it's going to be base 10. So when I go to data and start my regression, for my input y range, I'm picking the log of y. In my input x range, I'm just picking x. And I did include the labels for both of these, and I would like to output the residuals. Here, as you can see from our r-squared and adjusted r-squared, this model is not a very good fit for our data. The main reason for this is the fact that I randomly generated the data. But if we come down here to our coefficients, we have an intercept of 0.91 and a coefficient for x of 0.11. In both cases, the p-value shows that these values are significant for our equation. Since our r-squared values are so low, we know that it's not a very good fit, and we can tell that by looking at our line fit plot and our residual plot. There is no set pattern within the residual plot, but you can tell just by looking at it that it's still not a very good fit. So if we take our coefficients and we write it down in our equation, then we can see how to break this down further. So if we go back here, so what we had was the given y equals 0.0118 x plus 0.917. But if you remember from our Excel spreadsheet, we used a log of y for this calculation. So we go back here, the y is actually log of y. That means this is our log of a from the previous page. So what we need to do is we need to take it back to its original form. So here, log of y is y. So basically, to return a log of y to y, we just take it to a 10. We need to do the same thing for log of a. 10 to the log of a equals a. So if we take this value, 10 to the 0.0118 equals roughly 1.027. Now this all looks extremely complicated when you look at it this way, so we need to clean it up a bit. Our final equation comes out to y equals 1.027x plus, and if we had to do 10 to the for every value in here, we need to do it for the constant at the end as well. And that ends up being 8.273. And if you're a little confused about where this last part came from, if we go back to our original equation here and take into account the fact that there is a constant added, y equals a to the x plus b, when we break it down to logs, it ends up being log of y equals log of a times x plus log of b. So we have to do 10 to the on both sides to be able to get it back to its original equation.